Gotti is probably the only fighter today who can lose a fight and his fans won't abandon him.
Because of the way he's lost, not the result. They felt exhilarated and they felt good about being there.
November 2002.
Mickey Ward and Arturo Gatti start again with what may or may not be round 11 of their hellacious 10-round fight.
Whoa, what a good right to the body by Gatti that time.
It's been a big round so far, at least so it appears to these eyes for Arturo Gatti.
Very good, okay? Don't let us get caught pulling out. Everything is beautiful.
There's a great right hand by Gatti, and Mickey Ward goes down. You don't see that very often, and Ward's still wobbly. Let's see if Arturo can finish. Solid right hand there. Uppercut landed. Ward still punching back. They're doing it again in Atlantic City. Gatti Ward 2 already lives up to expectations.
Don't fall into this trap. You understand?
Yeah. Round 20. After 19 rounds of unbelievable combat between Mickey Ward and Arturo Gatti, they fight to the finish. Oh my goodness. Crowd on its feet in proper tribute to the two most compelling boxing performers of the year.
It was a worthy sequel.
June 2003.
Oh, big 1-2 by Arturo. Good left hook to the body by Gatti. No question, Arturo Gatti has hurt his right hand. Woods back in it now. Back in it in a big way.
What you want me to do?
My right hand.
What you want me to do?
Mickey Ward lands a solid straight right. Down goes Arturo. This is another incredible fight. Only 6 minutes to go.
Better round.
In the Gatti Ward trilogy.
2 rounds left, Arturo. Listen to me. Keep that jab in his face.
Arturo Gatti with a damaged right hand and down in the sixth. He has come back to dominate. The only title they fight for is the memory of their great three fights against each other. They're done. The third installment of this trilogy, no less glorious, no less memorable than its two already historic predecessors.
He had the biggest heart on any fighter I've ever seen in my life.
Pat Lynch was Gotti's manager for 18 years and witnessed the Ward trilogy firsthand.
In ninth round of the first fight, probably one of the most brutal rounds in boxing.
Arturo Gatti refusing to go down. Mickey Ward pounds away. Gatti's gonna survive the round.
At the end of that ninth round, trainer Buddy McGirt said he takes one more punch to start the tenth round. He goes, I'm not gonna let it go on.
Look at me, Arturo. I'm not gonna let you take this punishment.
Tenth round starts, and Gatti wins the whole tenth round like the ninth round never happened. Just shook my head. I'm like, I can't believe he just did that. He'd be willing to die in that ring before he would quit.
June 2005. Pretty boy Floyd Mayweather arrived in Atlantic City to face Gatti. Although a huge crowd favorite, Gatti was a big betting underdog against the pound-for-pound king. And Arturo was overmatched from the opening bell.
And Floyd hits Arturo with a left hook in the face, and now there's a knockdown in round one.
The punishment only got worse as Gatti was unable to match Mayweather's lightning speed.
Right hand is solid. Combinations by Mayweather. Too much speed. Maybe too much power, too. It's getting brutal in there as Mayweather fires at will. Floyd Mayweather promised exactly this. He promised he would humiliate Arturo Gatti before his fans. They're stopping it. And thank heaven.
Determined to bounce back from the Mayweather loss, Gatti returned to the ring to face Tomas Damgaard. Using his own speed and punching power, Gatti took control of the fight.
Gatti backed up against the ropes with a series of right uppercuts, hammers Damgaard. They trade at close range. And another huge left hook by Arturo Gatti. And another one. There's the difference in punching power, and now blood streaming from the mouth of Tomas Damgaard.
Amid the intense battle, Gatti once again seriously injured his right hand. But that wouldn't stop Arturo from throwing with reckless abandon.
Oh, and he bends over, cringing in pain after throwing the right to the body.
And hurt him with the right hand.
Let both hands go. He's annihilating a guy at close range who had won all of his previous fights. And now he's... Once again, the hero rises.
Arturo Thunder Gatti was found dead today in an apartment in Brazil. Gatti was on a second honeymoon with his wife and 10-month-old baby. He was discovered with blood stains on his neck and the back of his head. Few details are being released, but foul play is suspected. A champion at the junior lightweight and super lightweight divisions, Gatti was born in Italy, raised in Montreal, and later fought out of Jersey City, New Jersey. He burst onto the scene in December of 1995 with a thrilling knockout of then-champion Tracy Patterson. Also won an electrifying bout against Gabriel Ruelas 2 years later, lost a pair of wars with Ivan Robinson. But Gatti will best be remembered for his epic battles with Irish Mickey Ward, a trilogy in which he claimed two of the three fights. Gatti won Ring Magazine's Fight of the Year 4 different times, first in 1997 against Ruelas, then in 98 versus Robinson, and twice against Ward. Ring Magazine also recognized Gatti as its Comeback Fighter of the Year in 2002.
Last night, Arturo Gatti's friends, family, and admirers gathered in Jersey City to remember and honor the fallen boxer.
It's a word that you can't mention Arturo's name without mentioning his word, passion. Arturo Gatti fought with passion. Arturo Gatti lived with passion. Arturo Gatti loved with passion. He did everything in his life with passion. He loved life. I'm going to say that one more time. Arturo Gatti loved life. And I know, and you know, everyone in this room knows, and God knows, that Arturo Gatti never quit in his life. And Arturo Gatti did not quit in Brazil. And I hope you join me in praying that truth and justice prevail in figuring out what happened to our fight. You know, I was thinking to myself on this night, how many people really inspire us in our lives? You know, they love your parents, or people who are parents, or a priest, or a coach, or a teacher. If you're lucky to meet someone in life that inspires you. And one of the things I loved about my friend Arturo Gatti was, man, he inspired me, he inspired the world, he inspired millions of people. He constantly inspired by the way he fought in that ring, he inspired by the way he lived his life, he inspired by the passion that showed in everything. And he taught lessons to people. When you get knocked down, you get up. If you get knocked down again, you get up again. And if you keep getting knocked down, you keep getting up until God doesn't give you strength to get up again. When things look your weakest, when life is its darkest, when things are at their worst, when you're ready to give up, when there's peace inside you, you want to quit, you never quit, you never give up, you never give up. Arturo Gatti, you never gave up.
Talk a little bit about, you know, what your impressions were of Arturo Gatti, the person, not necessarily the boxer.
Very down-to-earth kind of guy. I think that's another reason why people were drawn to him. He had no ego about him. He never was a he never had an attitude about him, though. That was the weird thing about it. He always had a kind word for people. I mean, he was always surprised when people came up to him for an autograph, because he just he never thought he was anything really special, I don't think, at least to the, you know, the general public.
He was such a special person, and yet I think the most special thing about him was he didn't know it. And I think that is what everyone loved about him.
He's a kid that if my wife and I needed a babysitter when he was world champion, we needed to pick up the phone and call Saltoro, do me a favor, can you babysit? And he was. He was just a special person who died too young, tragically. It's just such a sad, sad thing.
He was by far, in a way, so over the top, the most exciting fighter in the world for a period of time that it's not even close. And there's lots of great fighters that were exciting. There was fighters that were more skilled. There was fighters that were bigger punchers, fighters that were bigger. But nobody had a bigger heart than Arturo Gatti.
I mean, you know, he just represented everything that anybody who ever, you know, laces on a pair of shoes wants to be like. I mean, you know, it's like they said it in there, you know, the guy just kept going, you know, he just kept coming. He was, you know, he trained great, it wasn't just about that, he had a big heart, you know, he'd go down, he'd come back up, or else he'd put you down and you wouldn't come back up, and it was just his fighting spirit, really, and he was one of the few fighters in a time when boxing's kind of going downhill that the people love to watch fight. I mean, you know, if I was shooting a movie, I'd tell the director, I ain't working at this particular hour because I'm going to watch Arturo fight, you know? I mean, that was more important to me than my job because he just brought so much to the table. And, it's not surprising that him and Mickey Ward became friends. You know, they both fought the same way. And, you know, he was just a people's champion, and it didn't matter whether he won or lost. It was the way he fought that we all loved. Well, it's about it's just coming back again when you know the gas tank is empty, and you know you just got to keep doing it. You got to go beyond the pain. You got to go beyond what's in your head. You got to go what's in your heart. And sometimes you're going on gas fumes and memory. You know, because everybody knows when they're not as quick as they used to be, their reflexes are going, or it's harder to make weight, but yet you got to keep moving forward. And the big tragedy here is somebody who fought so bravely for their whole life and gave us all so many thrills and taught us all so many lessons had to. Lose his life like the way he did in such a cheap, you know, evil fucking way.
You know, Arturo Gatti, man, he was all heart. He had the biggest heart. He had the biggest balls in boxing. Arturo, thank you for giving me the opportunity to fight you. It was a dream come true. It was one of the highlights of my life, and I will always take that with me. Arturo, rest in peace, and you will always remember.
You're a part of me, and it's your soul.